Hello guys, and welcome back to this channel. In today's video, we are going to continue our lesson on differential equations. We are going to look at the product rule. So given that y is a function of x, and then y is equal to the product of u and v. Now to find the derivative of y with respect to x using the product rule, we say that dy dx is equal to v times du dx plus u times dv dx. So let's pick an example to explain how to find the derivative of a function using the product rule. So for the first example, given that y is equal to 3x squared plus 1 times 5x minus 8, find dy dx. So let's rewrite the question. We have y equals 3x squared plus 1 times 5x minus 8. So let's say that let u equals 3x squared plus 1 and let v equals 5x minus 8. Now we know from the product rule that the derivative of y with respect to x is equal to v times du dx plus u times dv dx. So now we have the expression for u and then v respectively. So we need to find du dx and then dv dx. So that is exactly what we are going to do. So du dx means that we want to differentiate u with respect to x. Now we have u to be 3x squared plus 1. So when you differentiate 3x squared, you get 6x. You multiply 2 by 3, you maintain x, and then you decrease the power by 1. So that is 6x plus 1. Now when you differentiate a constant, you have 0. So du dx is equal to 6x. Now let's find dv dx. So we are also going to differentiate v with respect to x. Now when you differentiate 5x, you have 5. And then because negative 8 is a constant, when you differentiate that with respect to x, you have 0. Now back to the formula. So we have dy dx is equal to v. We have v to be 5x minus 8. So 5x minus 8 times du dx. Du dx is 6x. So times 6x plus u. U is 3x squared plus 1. So 3x squared plus 1 times dv dx, which is 5. So we have dy dx to be. Now let's simplify. So 5x times 6x is 30x squared. Negative 8 times 6x is negative 48x. 3x squared times 5 is 15x squared. And then 1 times 5 is 5. 30x squared plus 15x squared is 45x squared. And then we have negative 48x plus 5. So the derivative of y with respect to x is equal to 45x squared minus 48x plus 5. So this is how to use the product rule to find the derivative of a function. Now let's solve some more examples. So let's solve the second question. Now we have y equals x plus 1 times x cubed minus 2. And we are supposed to find dy dx. So we know from product rule that dy dx is equal to vin du dx plus u divin dx. So let u equals x plus 1 and let vin equals x cubed minus 2. Now let's find the u dx and divin dx. So du dx is equal to, now when you differentiate x you get 1, and when you differentiate 1, which is a constant, you have 0. Now let's move on to divin dx. We have vin to be x cubed minus 2, so when you differentiate x cubed you have 3x squared, and when you differentiate negative 2 you have 0. Now let's come back to the formula. We have dy dx equals vin. Now vin is x cubed minus 2, so we have x cubed minus 2 times du dx. Du dx is 1, so times 1 plus u. U is x plus 1 times divin dx. So divin dx is 3x squared. Now let's simplify. So 1 times x cubed minus 2 is still x cubed minus 2 plus 3x squared times x is 3x cubed, and then 3x squared times 1 is 3x squared. X cubed plus 3x cubed is 4x cubed, and then plus 3x squared minus 2. So we have dy dx to be 4x cubed plus 3x squared minus 2. Now let's solve the last question for today. So for the last question, we are to find dy dx given that y is equal to x minus 2 all squared times x squared plus 1. So there are two ways in solving this question. You can either choose to apply the product rule instantly, or you can expand x minus 2 all squared before you apply the product rule. Now for everyone to understand the solution, let's expand x minus 2 all squared. So x minus 2 all squared means that you have x minus 2 times x minus 2. Now x times x is x squared. X times negative 2 is negative 2x. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. And then negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. So we have x squared minus 4x plus 4. So this transforms to y equals x squared minus 4x plus 4 times x squared plus 1. So this is what we are going to focus on. Now let u equals x squared minus 4x plus 4, and let vin equals x squared plus 1. Now let's find du dx and divin dx. So du dx is equal to, when you differentiate x squared you have 2x, when you differentiate negative 4x you have negative 4. Now to divin dx, when you differentiate x squared you have 2x, when you differentiate a constant you have 0. So from the product rule, we know that dy dx is equal to vin times du dx plus u times divin dx. We have vin to be x squared plus 1. So x squared plus 1 times du dx is 2x minus 4. So 2x minus 4 plus, we have u to be x squared minus 4x plus 4. And then divide the x as 2x. So now let's expand. Now x squared times 2x is 2x cubed. X squared times negative 4 is negative 4x squared. 1 times 2x is 2x. 1 times negative 4 is negative 4. Plus x squared times 2x is 2x cubed. Negative 4x times 2x is negative 8x squared. And then 4 times 2x is 8x. So now let's simplify. Now 2x cubed plus 2x cubed is 4x cubed. Negative 4x squared minus 8x squared is negative 12x squared. And then 2x plus 8x is 10x. And then we have negative 4. So we have dy dx to be 4x cubed minus 12x squared plus 10x minus 4. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video. Bye bye.